Hey, what's up guys? Jay here with Solo YGO. Welcome to the channel if you're new. Welcome to Yu-Gi-Oh! If you're new. Today we're going to revisit last year's best set of the year. Definitely the best reprint set, of course. We have the 25th anniversary Rarity Collection. And this set's absolutely insane. We do have some things we need to revisit and try and go back for. Ruben, shout out. We're trying to get you a quarter century secret rare, reinforcements of the army. And of course, we'd love to get our hands on quarter century Ash just so we can buy another box of this. Be pretty nice. Guys, these boxes are not cheap. If you want to support, we got the Patreon down below or the YouTube channel memberships helps out. Every month we do a daily or a monthly giveaway. So this month we're giving out two of those tins back there, the 2023 mega tins. So if you want to qualify for that, you just have to answer the question of the day, which is, what is your favorite character from the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime? For me, it's probably gonna be Kaiba, but we do have Joey back there. Ruben donated him to the channel, so thank you for that. You guys can even do GX or 5Ds as well. Not really a big deal. Just trying to engage with you guys down in the comments below. So I should put these over here. All right, guys, let's get into the first one. See if we can pull some absolute bangers today. These are only 5-card packs. You got 2 super rares, and then you have the secret rare slot, which you can also have your quarter century secret rare, and then you have your ultra rare slots, which can have the new ultimate rare and the new collector's rare. Oh, the secret rare can also have the what's it called? Oops, I believe it's like this. Let's just try it straight up first time. The secret slot can also have that other secret rare rarity as well. All right, first off, we have Change of the Heart. Okay, so we're gonna have to figure out our positioning here. We got Ice Dragon's Prison. We got the secret rare. Didn't really need a reprint, but you know, they gave a lot of cards in here, reprints in the rarity collection, just to give us different rarities, of course. We got Dark Ruler No More, such a good board breaker. I wonder if this will ever be hit on the ban list eventually. Seems kind of balanced though, because there's no actual removal and your opponent can't be OTK'd, but that's just comparing to cards like evenly matched, of course. All right, next up we have Artifact Lancia and Mask Hero Darklaw. Okay, so I have no idea what I did there. I mixed up all the slots. Let's just do it straight up and see what we can get, where the positioning of everything is at. Straight up, here we go. All right, we have a super rare Lone Fire Blossom. Oh, we have the that special secret rare Reasoning. Keep forgetting what it's called, guys. I have no idea, but it's cool. It's got the kind of border. So secret rare is in the second slot. So it goes super secret, ultra Ben 10, ultra Chaos Space, and a super effect veiler. Nice, good pull right there. These are even just a buck just for bulk supers. So go super secret, ultra, ultra, super. Let's figure out if we can do a card trick for that. Interesting placement. I guess they wanted to sandwich the, at least sandwich the front and the back with super rares to protect ultra rares and secret rares, looks like. All right, so super rares on the back, and then secret rares right here, and ultras right there. Let's see if that worked. All right, we got Dengirsu, Orcus of the Evening Star, Artemis, Magicus Moon Maiden. For the first ultra rare, we have Borreload, Savage Dragon. Dang, I remember when any copy of this card was damn near 30 bucks. It's crazy how reprints can make a card so accessible. Dogmatica Punishment, nice. And, oh, we got Triple Tactics Talents Secret Rare. That's not a bad pull at all. That's worth, what, maybe $5, a little more? Not bad. Paid for the pack. These packs are what? There's 24 packs in a box, about 90 bucks per box, so do the math, but $5 is definitely not what the packs are costing, so That's our value back for that one at least. Here we go. All right, guys. First up, we got Herald of the Arc Light. Change of Heart. Beautiful. Tri-Brigade Revolt. Been seeing a ton of this at locals lately. Everybody's on that Tri-Brigade and Fire King deck, which I think we're probably going to make here because we have the structure decks. We need to actually open those on the channel, at least one of them, to showcase you guys and do a little review of it for quality control and all that, because as you guys know, the last couple structure decks have been decent, but before that, they had all the QA QC issues, especially with like the front card that was the ultra rare, always being messed up. Next up, we have Fairy Tale Luna. Nice little reprint there. And lastly, we have Ancient Fairy Dragon Seeker Rare. That's pretty. Of course, it's got the errata now, but nonetheless, good card. And I guess if you don't care about having the errata text, you can always throw it in your Edison deck. Those out of the way. How's your guys' week going? I got 9 more boxes of these, so I was like, I need to start opening them up. It's getting kind of crazy. Just having all these rarity boxes sitting there. And then I heard Ruben mention the quarter century secret rotor the other day again, so had to go in diving. Got Summit Limit. RIP his brothers, the other floodgates. This is one of the last one that actually stands, so not bad. Good option for decks that can pretty much just set up turn one and just sit on this and be good. For instance, Despia with a simple brand infusion on follow-up is more than enough to get you there. We got Egyptian God Slime, this 1000% needed reprint in this set, so Konami gave it to us. And here we go, the first ultimate rare. We have another Egyptian God Slime right in the second slot, so that can definitely happen with this set where it does that. You get them back to back, so that's cool. Let's see if we can get a 2-for-1 in this pack. We got a Dark Ruler No More. And for the secret rare slot, we have a Tour Guide from the Underworld, the regular one. So we got one in that pack. We got the ultimate rare God Slime, so we'll put that up there. Cool stuff. Don't cover up Time Magician or Time Wizard. There we go. This set was just so good, man. It's like nonstop dopamine rush every pack. It feels almost like Pokemon. Speaking of Pokemon, we have Charmander and Squirtle there in the background joining us. That's because we just recently started a Pokemon channel. I have no idea what we're going to do with it long term. I still haven't even learned how to play the game. But there's a bunch of people here locally, a bunch of my friends who like Pokemon. So I'm getting into it too because I love old card games. And right now we're at least opening up product over there because we sell it on our store. So might as well, you know, put it on camera and show you guys as well. All right, we have Selene, the Queen of Master Magicians. We got Alpha, the Master of Beasts. Oh, let's go. That's beautiful. Collector's Rare with the Speckled Eldritch the Golden Lord. Eldritch the Golden Lord. And that's nice. Dang, it's almost like I don't even want to play my OG secrets anymore. You just go ahead and play the Collectors of Ultras or even the Quarter Centuries and just feel so much better. Called by the Grave. And oh, 2-for-1. We got Quarter Century Secret Rare Decode Talker Heat Soul. Really good card, man. This is like a every turn draw. Great for those Cyburst Pile decks, which got hit by the circular ban recently, but still not a bad pool. All right, guys, next one. Let's see what we can get here. Come on, pack. Let's do this. And these boxes are so much quicker than Pokemon. All the Pokemon we did recently. It's like they're 36 card packs. 36 packs per box. 10 card packs. And Yu-Gi-Oh! Is like 24 cards, 24 packs per box, and then usually 7 cards. So this one's even just 5, but yeah. I mean, this is such a banger set. That's why the price is pretty comparable to the Pokemon boxes, regardless. Time Thief Redoer, super rare. Eldritch the Golden Lord. Another Egyptian God Slime. Dang, how many of these are we going to get today? We got a Junk Speeder. And for the secret rare, we got Small World. That's a beautiful pool. Small World, great staple. 3 of and a lot of decks that need consistency that are able to play it. And honestly, it did need a reprint because it had just gotten a reprint in 2022 tins. The card was already back up to $8 a copy, so Konami couldn't have any of that. They got to keep it affordable for the casual player base to keep players playing. And of course, it also helps them move product off the shelves when they can put expensive cards into reprint sets. Kind of entice you to go back to that product to hunt for those cards. All right, we got Cyber Angel Benten. Dark Ruler No More. We got Galaxy Eyes Full Armor Photon Dragon. Okay, we got Code Talker Inverted. We got the Collector's Rare. That's nice. Pretty card. And then we got Egyptian God Slime in the secret rare slot. We shall take another one of these. Seems like we can't get enough of them. Go ahead and toss that up there. I'm gonna start keeping a tally of how many God Slimes we get. Sheesh, if we can get that many Ash Blossoms, that'd be nice. Even the super rare in this set seems kind of short printed. Because there's a bunch of cards we've seen so many times, but the ever elusive Ash Blossom and Joyous Spring seems to remain hidden. I say that and I'll probably pull a quarter cent or secret rare in this pack. And we got Borreload Savage Dragon, super rare. Lava Golem Super Rare, nice reprint. Always a good board breaker. Oh, cool. We got the Ultimate Rare Dogmatica Ecclesia the Virtuous. Gorgeous card. I got the OG Ult from the OTS as well. Effect Veiler Ultra Rare, nice, good value there. Great staple. And for the Secret Rare, we got a Nightmare Unicorn. Regular Secret Rare. Still a beautiful card, nonetheless. Not bad. Alright, here we go. Oh, here we go. Right off rip, Pot of Prosperity Super Rare. Sitting at what, $6 or $7 now? Definitely about to flip this pretty quickly. We got Elder Entity Entis. For the first ultra, we have Summon Limit. Predaplant, Draco Stapella, Stapelia, and we got Junk Speeder, the special secret rare. For the life of me, I can't remember what it's called, but honestly, the best one of that pack, the Prosperity, of course. So we'll throw that up there so we don't forget to put it on TCG Player. Right back to it. What do you guys think they're gonna do this year for the fantastic reprint set of the year? Seems like every year there's at least one banger. A couple years ago it was what, Magnificent Mavens. Of course you had the original Ghost from the Past that everybody was hyped about originally. Same year as Magnificent Mavens, you had Ghost of Past 2, which was cool. A lot of good reprints there and a lot of cool ghost rares that have since plummeted in value. I guess they didn't age too well because of the quality control in that set. That was the first hint that Konami needed to get their ish together because, I think it's this one. Yeah. Because people were complaining quite a bit. All right, Win the Wind Channeler, super rare. Nice, super rare Baron DeFleur. Good staple. We got an ultra rare Lancia. Magician Salvation, and Secret Rare Dark Ruler No More. Nice. Remember when the OG Secret Rares out of the 2019s were always like $15 each? RIP those days. You guys can have your pick of the lot on rarities with that card now. Even the $5 ones from Spirit Charmer Structure Deck was nothing to laugh at. Now you can get them for like 5 cents. All right. All right, Code Talker Inverted. Danger Jackalope, RIP. Ooh, got Ultra Pot of Desires. Not bad to pull this since the card is back at 3. A lot of decks will be running this, of course, that can run it for consistency or for extra grind. Ultra Rare Nibiru the Primal Being, very nice. Card looks damn near a replica of the Ultra Rare from MP22. So, I mean, tells you something about where they've been at with the card stock. Hasn't changed much over the last year now. And we got Secret Rare Reasoning. We'll throw this in the goat bulk. Always nice for those Reasoning Gate decks. Now, if only they'd reprint what's the card called? God, I always forget it. The one that you pay 2,000 life points and both players special on as many from their banish as they possibly can. They need to reprint that card. Not Return from the Dimension, but the spell version of it. It's like Dimension something. And that card will never come off the ban list. All right, we got Nightmare Unicorn. Super Forbidden Droplet. Dang, like I said, non-stop Dopamine Rush. I remember when these were like over $100 just out of Brothers Legend. We got Ultra Rare Samoon the Poison Wind. Ruben, hit me up. I might have some higher rarity of these for you for your Blackwing deck that we just made you, because I just grabbed you the first three that I saw, which were super rares, but probably get some secrets from this set. I probably definitely have some. We got Ice Barrier, Ultra Rare, and oh, Quarter Century Secret Rare, the Winged Dragon Aras Spear Mode. This thing is so pretty. Oh, look at that. That's a nice pool. What's higher rarity, this or the Ghost Rare now? You tell me, but I think this one looks amazing. All right, probably the best pool so far. Let's keep it rolling. Come on, Konami, give me a Quarter Century Secret Ash Blossom. Let me buy like another 1.5 boxes of these. All right, here we go. Exodia's Left Nut, man, that's a good card. Outs 3 of your opponent's monsters, not an activated effect, just a summoning condition, so obviously it comes in and out of formats when it can be played. All right, I got the Iris Sword Soul, Tri-Brigade Revolt, Striker Dragon, Fallen of Albaz, and for the Secret Rare, we've got Chaos Space, RIP. Actually not a bad card to invest into, considering it's like 30 to 50 cents a copy, and it's an amazing card. It is limited to one, but I think Konami made a mistake limiting that card. It was probably just a slow Dragon Link temporarily, but that deck's not really a threat in general. Like to limit it because Dragon Link won Worlds is kind of like, it's kind of like rebanning Maxi over here. It wasn't relevant because it's Worlds. Dragon Link wasn't doing anything crazy before that. And it still isn't. Ooh, nice. Super Rare Lightning Storm. So yeah, I think Chaos Space will come back eventually. It's a good one, and it's a great card too. Reasoning. Or they could have it, you know, because the Lightsworn stuff too. That might be a preemptive hit to that. You never know. But that Lightsworn support coming back, it would have been an amazing thing for Chaos Space to come back, to give Lightsworn some kind of relevancy. All right, we got Downer Magician. Ooh, Ultra Rare Baron DeFleur. And for the Secret Rare, we have Pot of Prosperity again. Let's go. You're going to have to cover up your Super Rare brother. You're a bit shinier than him. Let's go. Secret Rare Pot of Prosperity. That's a nice one. Gonna have to remember to post those right away. I'd never trust Konami with the ban list. I think Pot of Prosperity should have been cut quite a while ago. I play the hell out of that card, though, in any deck I can. Any deck where it's viable. Not gonna hurt me too much with my extra deck or anything like that. So, Exorcisters, Flunderies, just to name a couple. Alright, Ice Dragon's Prison. There we go. We got the Super Ash Blossom after I mentioned earlier how we hadn't seen this. It's almost short printed, to be honest. We got Ultra Rare Lightning Storm. Ultra Rare Nightmare Unicorn. And, oh my god, it's so beautiful. We got the Mask Hero Dark Lost Seeker Rare. Heroes players, raise your hands in the comments. It's good that they reprinted that card. I mean, that thing was like $4 or $5 for any copy. Obviously, just a really good card. It's a one-sided D-Shifter or Macrocosmos, whatever you want to call it. And it's every one time, once per turn, if your opponent adds a card from their deck to hand, you get to discard a card at random. So that's pretty freaking good, if you ask me. All right, first up, we got Fairy Tail Luna. Come on. There we go. We got Fallen of Albaz. Ooh, Ultimate Rare Magician's Salvation. Guys, I really like the Ultimate Rares in this set. I mean, seeing the sparkle right there. Look at the way it, you know, it's kind of like the actual artwork's kind of raised above it. It's just so nice. Oh, and right back to back, we got Collector's Rare Called by the Grave. That's nice. We're definitely gonna throw this in one of our decks. This card's virtually in every deck we own. Card's freaking busted. And Preparation of Rites. Seek Rare, we couldn't finish it off with a threefer, but we did get two high rarity cards in that pack. That's pretty nice. Guys, we got like 8 packs left. We're zipping through these. This set's amazingly good, but there ain't many cards in each box. Just a 24 card or 24 pack per box set with 5 cards per pack. So what's that, 120 cards per box? Yep, not the most. 120, that's crazy. Pokemon has 10 cards per pack and 36 packs per box. So that's like 1/3 of it. That's 360. That's crazy. Here we go. That there. First up, we have Dogmatic Ecclesia the Virtuous, super rare. Compulsory Evacuation Device. First time we've seen this today. I've been loving these guys. I like the Seek Rare one from this set too. It's not that expensive either. You can get some on TCG for what, like 70 cents maybe? Dollar? Get yourself some Seek Rare copies. They look really nice. And it's good for old formats too. Pick up a couple play sets, have a modern one for your modern or advanced deck, and then one for Go Edison. Not bad. Ultra Rare D-Shifter. I wouldn't recommend stocking up on these with that being said, because this card would be on the next ban list with Prosperity if I had to guess. All right, we got Lava Golem, or at least limited to one, because nobody's going to play it at one, or semi-limited. If you semi-limit it, then you have to be really ballsy, because the math between 2 and 3 in your deck and hard seeing it first turn is quite substantial. And then, oh, we got the special Seeker Rare Tri-Brigade Revolt. Very nice, extra Seeker Rare-ish. Pretty cool. Been seeing way too many Shirags at locals lately. I wouldn't be happy when it goes away. I've actually kind of enjoyed seeing Tri-Brigade, but it is annoying as hell. I am now not gonna not run 3 Ghost Ogres in my deck because of that deck, and then also some other decks in the format. But it's just seeing way too many Apollosas as well. That deck plays it and it sets up like 3 negates on turn 1. So gotta have my Apollosa out. Oops. Here we go. All right, first up we got Super Rare Decode Talker Heat Soul. Next up, we have Super Rare Ghost Trick Angel of Mischief. Oh, that's gorgeous. Ultimate Rare Vision Hero Ferris. If you guys know me, Ultimate Rare is my favorite rarity. I've been meaning to get some of these, so there you go, I got it. I am changing out my Ferrises and my Hero deck to Ultimate Rares. Even though this is kind of like a poor man's Ultimate Rare, it's an Ultimate Rare nonetheless, and it's still rigid. I like it. Like I said, I kind of like how the artwork's raised above, so we'll take it. And next up, we have a Collector's Rare IDP Ice Dragon's Prison. This is a pack is already a twofer. Let's see if we can go for the third one. Secret Rare. Oh, we got Secret Rare Nibiru the Primal Being. So this pack ended up being an amazing pack nonetheless. That's ridiculous, just getting all that at one pack. You go in front of Exodia's left testy, and you go in front of Prosperity. Well, we got five more packs, guys. That means we went through 19 so far. We'll do that one last. That one probably has the Quarter Century Ash in it. Still on the hunt for Rubens Rota, so let's see if we can get that. I told him, man, if we don't get it, I'm just gonna order you one. I refuse to go down like that. I got 9 more boxes after this to open up, so we're gonna not give them to you guys week after week. It'd be a little boring. We'll spread them out, of course. This is a nice set to even revisit next year, maybe, so we'll see how far we spread them out. All right, Super Rare Ghostbell and Haunted Mansion. Super Samoon. Ultra Time Thief Redoer. Got a Cherubini and Mud Dragon of the Swamp, Secret Rare slot. All right, pack was a little underwhelming. Not a single high rarity card, and also not really anything useful in general for deck building or things that we can flip back on the secondary market to buy some more boxes for openings. All right, first up we have Blue Eyes Abyss Dragon, number 100 Numeron Dragon. Oh, you see that foiling on the edge? There's a Quarter Century Secret back there. All right, guys. Ultra Rare Forbidden Droplet. Galaxy Eyes Full Armor Photon Dragon. And for the Quarter Century Secret Rare, we have... Oh! Evenly matched. Oh, that's amazing. I don't even know how much this is going for. It's got to be something, though. Evenly matched, such a good staple. Oh, that's beautiful. I don't even know if I want to sell this. Look at that stamp. Quarter Century Secret Rare stamp. I love it. That's nice. All right, guys. Let's go right in the center. We got Secret or Quarter Century Secret Rare left testy and evenly matched. That's crazy. Both cards just scream get fucked. That's crazy. We just got the Board Breakers. Board Breakers are my favorite card. If I had to choose between like Hand Traps, Floodgates, Board Breakers, all the delinquent stuff. I absolutely love going second builds with all blowout cards. So yeah, evenly matched. That's a real thing. Card might not last forever. I've been speculating being banned for a while, or at least limited, semi-limited. All right, we got Ferris, a super rare. Darklaw, super rare. Magicalized Fusion. Oh, we got an extra up, nice. Nice little ultra rare slot there. And for the secret rare, we have Mech Knight Crusadia Avermax. He's a good one. He's a good Link 4. Cyburst. I've always loved his artwork. Nice card. Of course, he got reprinted back in Maze of Memory, so wasn't really too much of a need for him in this set. But like I said, the good cards, the good staples, they threw him back in here regardless. Double down on him. Make sure they don't raise in value again for some time being, and then also give you some different rarities to go hunting for when you crack in product. All right, next pack. Let's see what we can get here. Guys, this is the second to last one. We got our Quarter Century Secret Ash Blossom there. So if you've made it this far, go ahead and like the video. Subscribe if you think we earned your subscription. Leave a comment down below the daily question, which was, what is your favorite OG character from one of the shows? Told you mine's Kaiba. If I had to go 5Ds, probably Yusei. And then GX. Let's go with Elemental Hero Sparkman. Alright, Ancient Fairy Dragon. D-Barrier. The card's been so insane for me lately at locals. I would not be surprised if this gets hit as well. Infinite Impermanence Ultra Rare. Okay, that's really good. You can always use more Imperms. Reasoning Ultra Rare. And Herald of Darklight Seeker Rare. But we'll take that Imperm for sure. Let me take that out, actually. Put these in my decks. Card will probably never be banned. Just an overall super a fair card. And I do like particularly that Imperm right now plays around cards like Tactics and Thrust. I just think it makes it that much stronger. All right, guys, last pack. Let's see if we get some magic here. Super rare on the front. Secret rare on the back. And we're ready to go. Let's see what we can get for this very last pack of the quarter century, or sorry, of the 25th Rarity Collection. First up, we have Called by the Grave. Dimension Shifter. Ecclesia in the first Ultra slot. Lone Flower Blossom. Okay, guys, no special rarities in this pack yet. Let's see what we can get in the secret rare slot. And for the last pack of this box opening, the last card we have, Eldritch the Golden Lord. Regular Seeker Rare. Looks exactly like the OG one. A little bit of different card stock, but nothing special there, guys. We did, however, get some major bling throughout the course of this video. Let's go back and reveal the ones of note. We got a quarter century Seeker Rare, evenly matched, probably the best one. Ultimate Rare, Vision Hero Ferris. Can I put that directly into my deck? Quarter Century Spear Mode. Ultimate Rare Ecclesia. Ulti God Slime. The Special Revolt. Ulti Salvation. Collector's Rare Callbreaker. That's a really good one too. I need to put that in my deck as well. Let's actually stick that over there. Quarter Century Seeker Rare Vico Talker Heat Soul. Ultra Rare Infinite Impermanence. Collector's IDP. A Seeker Rare Pot of Prosperity for good measure. And a Super Rare Pot of Prosperity. The Collector's Inverted Talker. And a Secret Tactics Talents. I'd say overall, this box break was pretty good. I don't know if we got all 90 bucks back. But definitely got some cool cards regardless. I don't know what the evenly matched or the Spear Mode are going for. Probably will tell a lot of it. So yeah, guys, again, like the video, subscribe, comment down below that daily question, and we'll see you in the next one. Peace out.